Welcome to the class. Today we are going to deal about Stern Gerlach experiment. Let us recollect what we have done till now. Till now we have seen that Bohr's atom model could not explain the fine structure of the spectral lines for atoms. So that an improvement over Bohr atomic model is Stern-Gerlach experiment. A Stern-Gerlach experiment verifies the vector atom model, concepts of vector atom model, which are space quantization and spin of the electron. So until now we have seen that due to vector atom model, there are two quantum numbers arise, which are one is magnetic orbital quantum number, the other one is magnetic spin quantum. These two, so the main concept of vector atom model is space quantization and electrons. These two are verified by using Stern-Gerlach experiment. So let us see the experimental setup. Stern-Gerlach experiment. You can see in the figure the experimental setup of Stern-Gerlach experiment. In Stern-Gerlach experiment, you can see here the parts of the Stern-Gerlach experiment. One is oven. You can see a oven is a instrument where you can heat, and here we are using silver atoms in the oven. And the next part is two slits. They are also called as collimator. That is, the silver atoms which are heated in the oven come out of the oven in the form of a beam. This beam passes through two slits so that the beam of silver atoms is parallel and straight. So the first part of the our experiment is in the experimental arrangement, one is oven where silver atoms are heated. These silver atoms pass through two slits or collimators which make the beam straight, and this is the important part of the our experiment. So you can see here north pole and south pole. So as you can notice from the figure, there is a difference between the magnetic poles or magnets. That is north pole and south pole. Here the north pole is having a cylindrical flat surface, as you can see here. See, cylindrical flat surface. But here in the south pole of the magnet, the two poles of the magnet, the south pole is designed in such a way that you can see that the south pole is having a sharp knife edge, as you can see here. So one end of the pole is sharp and one of the north pole is flat, cylindrically flat, flat cylindrical surface. South pole is having a sharp edge, knife edged surface. And the last part of the of our experimental arrangement is photographic plate. So you can see here on the photographic plate there is a silver atoms have formed an image on the photographic plate, which we will see later. So here from the PowerPoint presentation, you can see in the Stern-Gerlach experiment, a beam of silver atoms is passed through a inhomogeneous magnetic field. In Stern-Gerlach experiment, a beam of silver atoms is passed through an inhomogeneous magnetic field. How is this inhomogeneous magnetic field created? The inhomogeneous magnetic field is created by using two the poles of the magnets. One is flat, the other one is having a knife edge. So the silver atom beam is produced by heating silver atom in a small electric oven O and passing the beam through slits S1 and S2 or collimators. So you can see here, once again I am repeating, see, silver atoms are heated in the oven, which form a beam and travel through two slits or collimators and pass through a inhomogeneous magnetic field created by a magnet with a sharp knife edge of south pole and cylindrically flat surface of the north pole, and a photo they form an image on the photographic plate. So next, so here in inhomogeneous magnetic field is produced having one of the pole pieces of the magnet flat with a cylindrical groove and the other in the form of a knife edge parallel to the groove as shown in the figure. So you can just see the figure once again. So inhomogeneous magnetic field is created by flat cylindrical surface north pole and a sharp knife edge which are parallel to each other, and the silver atoms pass through this inhomogeneous magnetic field, which is very very important. You have to note that the silver atoms pass through an inhomogeneous magnetic field. So south pole is having a knife edge, thus the magnetic field of is of much greater intensity. See, concentrate on this point. Why is the magnetic field is of greater intensity near the knife edge? Because of the shape, it is inhomogeneous magnetic field. Towards the sharp end of the pole, the magnetic lines of force are more. So, intensity of magnetic field near the sharp knife edge is more. So, thus the magnetic field is of much greater intensity near the knife edge than anywhere else in the gap, that is between the north and south pole. So the intensity of the magnetic field increases as we go from the center towards the upper knife edge pole and decreases as we go below towards the lower pole or north pole. The magnetic field increases, see here, once again you see the figure. The magnetic field increases as we go, that is as the silver atoms move from center towards the sharp knife edge or south pole, and the magnetic field decreases as the silver atoms move from the center towards the cylindrically flat north pole. So here, as the silver atoms are moving towards the south pole, the magnetic field intensity increases, and towards the north pole or the lower end, the magnetic field decreases. So there is a gradient of the magnetic field developed across the magnetic. So there is a gradient. There is a one on one side of the magnetic pole, there is more magnetic field, and on other side, there is a the intensity of the magnetic field decreases. So a photographic plate P records, as we have seen in the apparatus, the last part of the our experimental arrangement, magnet photographic plate P records the configuration of the beam after its passage through the field. So to avoid the deflection of silver atoms by gas molecules, the whole arrangement is enclosed in a highly evacuated glass vessel. You can see here, the whole arrangement of the Stern-Gerlach experiment, total, it is enclosed in a highly evacuated glass vessel, because the silver atoms, after coming from the oven, they may disperse, that is they may go to other directions, but we want all the silver atoms to pass through this inhomogeneous magnetic field where they create a pattern on the photographic plate. So the total apparatus is again placed in a evacuated glass vessel, which you have to concentrate. So now you can see how the why there is a more intensity of the magnetic field. See, in the figure here, you can see magnetic lines of force side view. So along the z-axis, that is as you are going to the south pole, towards the south pole here, from center towards the south pole, you can see the concentration of the magnetic lines of force here. You can see more number of magnetic lines. So that is magnetic field intensity at the south pole, with the sharp edged south pole. Is more magnetic field intensity at the sharp edged south pole is very high, and that is shown by this magnetic lines of force. So in the absence of magnetic field, a trace of the form of narrow strip is obtained, that is just a line, a single line is obtained on the photographic plate, which is not shown here in the figure. And in the presence of inhomogeneous magnetic field, the strip is split into two components. Here, see, you can see from the Stone Gerlach experiment, or you can see from the figure here, our experimental arrangement. See here, you can see two parts. The beam here, it is split into two parts, and an image is formed on the photographic plate. So the silver beam is split into two parts here. See, you can see. But according to the classical concepts, here the two splitting of the silver beam into two parts, as shown in the figure here, is not seen. It's obtained in the form of a continuous strip. According to the classical concepts, the classical shape of the strip is in the inhomogeneous magnetic field is as shown here, as just like a strip. So, as you are going from the north pole to the south pole, or from center to the north pole, magnetic field intensity, what happens? It decreases. As you are going to the sharp knife edge, from center towards the silver atoms, and they are going from center to the sharp knife edge or the south pole, the magnetic field intensity increases. So, here after passing through the inhomogeneous magnetic field, the beam is split into two parts as seen by Stern and Gerlach. But according to classical physics, classical theory, there is only a continuous strip, there is no splitting. So, this verifies the spin of the electron. So, the splitting of the silver beam into two components in the inhomogeneous field verifies the existence of electron spin. Splitting into two parts, and the postulates of space quantization is verified by Stern-Gerlach experiment. That is, by seeing the figure on the photographic plate, you can confirm that the electron spins, that is, parallel and anti-parallel spins, clockwise and anti-clockwise direction of the electron around the nucleus. So, this proves the electron spin of the electron. That is, on the photographic plate, when silver atoms pass through an inhomogeneous magnetic field, they form they are split into two parts. That is, magnetic moment is split into two parts. One is parallel due to parallel spin, the other one is due to anti-parallel spin. So here you can see. So by this experiment, one of the concepts, that is electron spin, is verified. So let us go to the next slide. So you can see here, the electronic configuration of silver atoms, see, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, and 5s1. That is, it is nothing but all up to 4d10. That is, 1s2 completely filled orbital, 2s2 completely filled orbital, 2p6 completely filled orbital. Similarly, up to 4d10, all are completely filled. But this electron, that is 5s electron, is responsible for the magnetic field or moment, magnetic moment of the total silver atoms in the, when they are passing through the magnetic field. So, the atomic number of silver atom is, we know that it is 47. So, according to Pauli's exclusion principle, the inner shells and subshells are completely filled except the outermost 5s state. You can see here, the electron, from the electronic configuration of 5s, that is, last electron is 5s1, only one electron is there, it is not completely filled. So, this is responsible for the magnetic moment of the silver atom. The silver atom is monovalent, so 5s electron is responsible for the magnetic moment of the atom. So, we cannot take the oven, you can see here from the figure. In the oven, we cannot take a single silver atom. There will be a number of silver atoms. That is, you will take a powdered form. You will take it in a powdered form. And from there, when you are taking powdered silver in the oven, the atoms are coming into the, passing through the slits, and then coming to the, and passing through the inhomogeneous magnetic field, and the beam is split into two parts, which verifies the electron spin. So, here you can see the main component of magnetic moment is the 5s electron is responsible for the magnetic moment of the atom. When all silver atoms possessing a magnetic moment, mu j pass through the inhomogeneous magnetic field, they experience different amounts of force in the vertical direction depending on their orientation. So the silver atoms are moving in the evacuated glass jar of the experimental setup is totally placed in an evacuated glass vessel. So they are moving in different directions and they have different magnetic moments, experience different amounts of force also in vertical direction depending on their orientation. So this is due to the fact that when a bar magnet is placed in inhomogeneous magnetic field where north pole experiences greater force than south pole, here it should be written as south pole experiences a greater force than north pole, because south pole is knife edged in our figure. Then the magnet experiences a resultant force which is F1 minus F2, that is the magnetic force due to atoms, silver atoms which are going towards the south pole is more, whereas the magnetic the silver atoms which are coming towards the north pole, flats north pole, is less. So the total resultant force is F1 minus F2. So the 5s electron is responsible for the total magnetic moment. So the magnitude and direction of the force depends on the magnitudes F1 and F2, that is orientation of the axis of the magnet relative to the magnetic field. This force causes a deflection, or this is nothing but gradient is caused. Deflection of the silver atoms to varying degrees in the vertical direction. If the magnetic moment mu j can have all possible orientations according to classical view, then the beam of silver atoms consisting of millions of atoms having all possible orientations is spread out into a broad continuous band on emerging from the magnetic field. In this way, it should produce a broad continuous patch on the photographic plate. But what do we see? Experimentally, only two narrow strips are obtained on the photographic plate. Therefore, the predictions of classical physics are not correct in the case. See, here you can see only two strips, or you can see the previous slide here. You can see from the Stern-Gerlach experiment, only two strips. The beam is split into two parts. But according to classical physics, because all the atoms have different orientations, these orientations must produce a continuous patch according to classical physics. But what we are seeing from the experiment, there are only two parts in the split beam. That is, only the silver atom or the silver atoms after passing through the inhomogeneous magnetic field form only split into two components, which proves that Stern-Gerlach experiment electron spin of the atom. So therefore the predictions of classical physics, that is a continuous patch, is not obtained according to classical physics. So now you can see the two narrow strips show mu j cannot have all possible orientations but only two possible orientations as shown in the figure. We know that mu j is proportional to the angular momentum j, and hence the direction of j relative to a well-defined direction should have only two values. Direction of j and s relative to well-defined direction should have only two values. According to the quantization rules, the magnitude of j is given by j is equal to square root of j into j plus 1 into h by 2, where j is total angular momentum quantum number. According to the vector atom model, j is total angular momentum quantum number. That is, so here you can see j is equal to, according to the magnitude of j is root of j into j plus 1 into h by 2 pi. There are 2j plus 1 possible orientations of j. The Stern-Gerlach experiment shows that 2j plus 1 is equal to 2. How? Or j is equal to half. How? Because here you can see the subshells of the, according to vector atom model, are spdf. You can see the 5s electron of silver atom. Here see the electronic configuration. You can see 5s electron is responsible for the orientations or the magnetic movement of the electron. So s is nothing but orbital quantum number for s. Orbital is 0. So only the total angular momentum j, quantum number j, is only half. That is, s is equal to plus half and minus half. So j is equal to plus half. So here you can see from the formula j into j plus 1 square root of j into j plus 1 into h by 2 pi. So because orbital quantum number s, l is equal to 0, that is s orbital. So here only total angular momentum quantum number j is equal to half, or j is equal to, here according to the magnitude of j is root 3 by 2, that is half into half plus 1, that is root 3 by 2 into h by 2 is the total quantum